First Samuel chapter 30. Then it happened when David and his men came to Ziklag. On the third day, Ziklag we'll understand Ziklag a little more today. On the third day, that the Amalekites had made a raid on Negev and on Ziklag and had overthrown Ziklag and burned it with fire. And they took captive the women and all who were in it, both small and great, without killing anyone, and carried them off and went their way. When David and his men came to the city, behold, it was burned with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters had been taken captive. Then David and his people who were with him lifted their voice and wept until there was no strength left in them. Amen. And verse 5, it says, now David's two wives had been taken captive, Ahinom and Abigail, the widow of Nabal. Verse 6, moreover, David was greatly distressed because the people spoke of stoning him, for all the people were embittered, each one because of his son and his daughter. And here's what I want you to underline. But David, say, but David. But David strengthened himself in the Lord. Amen? Come on, guys. But David, what did he do? मैं आपको ये हिंदी में भी पढ़ के सुनाता हूँ. और दाऊद बड़े संकट में पड़ा क्योंकि लोग अपने बेटी बेटियों के कारण बहुत शोकित होकर उस पर पथरावा करने का चर्चा कर रहे थे. परंतु दाऊद ने अपने परमेश्वर यहोवा को स्मरण करके हियाब बांधा. आमेन. दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू स्पीक टू यू अबाउट. डेविड फाउंड एनकरेजमेंट इन द लॉर्ड. David strengthened himself in the Lord. Amen? Are you with me? Now, the background is very beautiful. You have to understand. Ye kahani ka jo background hai, wo bahut hi sundar hai. Ek sadharan sa ek ladka hai. Achanak se ek din charwaha hai. Achanak se ek din uske paas Samuel, us zamane ka sabse bada prophet, jiska ek lafz bhi galat nahi gaya hai. Wo aata hai uske ghar mein aur use abhishekt karta hai. और उससे कहता है कि तू राजा बनेगा, इज़राइल का राजा बनेगा. आमीन. नाउ ही इज सपोज टू बी द किंग ऑफ इज़राइल, बट बिटवीन द अनॉइंटिंग एंड द क्राउन देयर वाज अ 13 टू 14 ईयर पीरियड वेयर ही वाज जस्ट रनिंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अदर. आमीन. बिटवीन द प्रॉमिस एंड द फुलफिलमेंट. आमीन. There was a time of testing that he went through. Amen. And here is David, anointed to be king, walks in and fights Goliath. And now suddenly all of Israel is singing a song. Israel is saying, Saul has killed his 1,000, David has killed his 10,000. Come on, talk to me. Amen. Saul has killed his 1,000. Saul महान है, बहुत बड़ा काम करता है, बहुत लोगों को मारा है, लेकिन दाऊद उससे 10 गुना ज्यादा करता है. आमेन. वो राजा नहीं है, लेकिन वो राजा से भी ज्यादा अभिषक्त है. आमेन. एंड द पीपल आर सिंगिंग दीज सॉन्ग्स एंड Saul starts फीलिंग jealousy. Amen. And Saul, out of his jealousy, अपने द्वेष के कारण, वो क्या करता है? वो ये निर्णय लेता है कि वो दाऊद को खत्म कर देगा, दाऊद को मार देगा. और अब दाऊद उस जगह से, राजा के पास से निकलकर भाग रहा है. भागते भागते वो एक स्थान पर आता है जिसका नाम है Ziklag. Comes to a place called Ziklag. Amen. And now he is in this place called Ziklag, where the king is King Achish. वहाँ का राजा कोई और है. उस राजा के पास ये अपने आप को बताता है और कहता है कि मैं आपका सेवा करूँगा, और वो कॉम्प्रोमाइज करता है. Now this is what we need to understand. Amen. ये जो बात है ये हमें समझना है कि परमेश्वर हम सब के साथ एक योजना बनाता है. Amen. God has a plan for each one of us. Amen. For some it may be a ministry, for some it may be business, for some it may be a career. But God has a plan for each one of us. Amen. And between the promise and the fulfillment of the promise, there lies a Ziklag. Come on, are you getting this? There lies a place called Ziklag. Amen. And David is in Ziklag right now. Amen. David has come and compromised against his own king. David has compromised. He is not killing the Israelites, but he has told King Achish that I am with you. और उसको जब कभी भी उसको बोलता है कि आपको जाके वहां पर मारना है या वहां पर युद्ध करना है, वो वहां पर जाकर दूसरे लोगों को मारकर उनका पैसा लेकर आता है. Amen? Because he will not fight against God's people. But at the same time, he has now entered a place of compromise. Am I making sense to you? Yes. Am I making sense to you? He has entered a place of compromise. And God does not want your testimony to be a testimony of compromise. Are you getting this? Every Ziklag in your life will be burnt down. You didn't hear me. I said every Ziklag in your life will be burnt down. Parmeshwar aapka har Ziklag ko jala dalega. क्यों जला डालेगा? क्योंकि परमेश्वर यह नहीं चाहता है कि आपकी गवाही में कोई ज़िकलाग हो. आमीन. परमेश्वर यह नहीं चाहता है कि आपके जीवन में कोई ऐसा स्थान हो जहां पर आपको शर्मिंदगी फील करना पड़े या महसूस करना पड़े. परमेश्वर यह चाहता है कि जब आप खड़े होकर आप अपनी गवाही दे तो आप ये नहीं बोला रहे हो वो मैंने वैसा किया था पास्टर लेकिन परमेश्वर ने यह किया. नो 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 नो, द लॉर्ड फॉट माई बैटल फॉर मी. My God is stronger than any Goliath and enemy Amalekite that can come in my way. Amen. And so my God will fight my battles for me. Amen. Whether it is a broken marriage or whether it is a messed up business or whether it is debts or whether it is any kind of a problem, my God can fight every battle for me. Amen. And if you are going to compromise, God is going to burn that down because he has a greater plan with you. Hallelujah. And so David comes and stays in this place called Ziklag. And the Bible says in the previous chapter, if you go down, you will see David was in this place for 16 months. 16 mahina wo wahan par chup kar raha. Jhoot bolte hue. हम लोग भी रहते हैं 16 नहीं शायद ज्यादा रहते हैं. परमेश्वर ने मुझे ये बोला है, परमेश्वर ने मुझे वो बोला है, जो कि आपको खुद को मालूम है परमेश्वर ने नहीं बोला है. और सभी लोगों को कहता है गवाही है. बट गॉड विल बर्न इट डाउन चर्च. गॉड विल बर्न डाउन एवरीथिंग दैट स्टैंड्स इन द वे ऑफ हिज टेस्टिमनी. Amen. And so 16 months he's hiding there. And he comes one day from a war. He's coming because he's depressed now. Dukhi hai wo. Kyu dukhi hai? Kyunki wahan ka raja Akish usse kehta hai ki ab tu yudh nahi karega hamare saath. Do you know the reason? Raja ke jo saath mein log the na, wo log kehne lagte hain, ये तो वही दाऊद है जिसके बारे में कहा गया था सॉल हैज स्लेन हिज 1000 डेविड हैज स्लेन हिज 10,000. द वेरी सॉन्ग्स दैट वी यूज्ड टू प्रेज यू हैज नाउ बिकम अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर यू. द वेरी थिंग्स दैट वॉज बींग यूज्ड टू लिफ्ट यू अप हैज नाउ लिफ्टेड यू अप टू सच अ डिग्री दैट यू कैन नॉट हाइड. आर यू गेटिंग दिस? Amen? Are you getting this? Oh, he's a famous photographer. And suddenly the very fact that you are a photographer is what is keeping you from being called anointed. The very fact that you are talented as a businessman or as a singer or as anything that you can think of is now being used against you and they say, we cannot have this man fighting on our side. Ye toh humare hi khilaaf aa jayega. आज तो ये इजरायली लोगों के खिलाफ युद्ध के लिए जा रहा है, हमारे परमेश्वर के लोगों के खिलाफ युद्ध पे जा रहा है. ये नहीं लड़ेगा, ये घूम जाएगा और कहता है इसको बाहर निकालो. दाऊद कहता है मैंने कभी कुछ गलत किया है आपके सामने? कहता है पता नहीं, गलत किया या सही किया तुझे जाना है। दाऊद वहां से निकलता है दुखी होकर, अपने घर आ रहा है, और जब वो घर पहुंचता है तो दूर से उसे धुआं दिखता है, दूर से उसे आग दिखता है, क्योंकि उसके तंबू, उसका घर सब कुछ जला दिया गया है। उसके बच्चे, बीवियां, साथ में जो लोग हैं उनके बीवी बच्चे सभी को अमालेकाइट्स लेकर चले गए। हुआ दीज अमालेकाइट्स, ये अमालेकाइट, ये लोग जो है वो कौन है? ये ऐसे लोग हैं जिसके खिलाफ परमेश्वर को सख्त नफरत है। Are you with me? The Bible says that the Amalekites were a people that God hated. God wanted them finished because the Amalekites represent your flesh. God, I want to walk with you, but I am weak when I see some things. God, I want to walk with you, but every time I cross that shop, and God says, Amalekite spirit. See, there is a Pharaoh spirit that stops you from worshiping God. Amen. Let my people go that they may worship. Amen. Are you with me? There is a Jezebel spirit that seduces you, keeps you away from the presence of God. Are you with me? There is an Amalekite spirit, a spirit of the flesh that stops you and preys on your weakness. Amalekites kya karte the? Jab Israeli log desert mein se, desert, Registan se jab ja rahe the, to kya hota tha? Ki peeche se aakar attack karta tha. Aur jo kamzor hai, jo buzurg hai, unko attack karkar unko apna bandak bana dete the. And God used to hate this. God told Saul, finish them off. Amen. The word says David continually sought the face of God. How did he inquire of the Lord? How did he pray? How did he worship? See, the book of Psalms is all about this. The book of Psalms constantly keeps telling us how David used to seek God. Look at Psalms 34, 1 to 4. Another difficult situation in his life when he wrote this. Amen. He was behaving like a mental. He was behaving like a madman. And then he sits in some corner and this is what he writes. He writes, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Can you underline continually? Oh, my soul will make boast in the Lord. The humble will hear of it and rejoice. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his mighty name. Amen. Underline, my soul will make boast. Underline boast and magnify in verse 3. It doesn't matter whether I have that job or not. It doesn't matter whether I have that relationship or not, whether I have that career or not. It doesn't matter. Those things don't matter. Those are all secondary, church. I will bless the Lord at all times. Amen. His praise will continually be in my lips, not my complaints. Not this, ये हम लोग बार बार जो कुड़कुड़ाते रहते हैं ना, वो नहीं, हम परमेश्वर की आराधना करेंगे। Amen? हर परिस्थिति में, हर सिचुएशन में, जीवन के हर मोड़ पे हमें क्या करना है? बस बहुत आसान है, परमेश्वर का आराधना करना है। What happens? Says verse 2, please. My soul shall make her boast in God, the meek shall hear thereof and be glad. My soul will make boast in the Lord. That my God is bigger than every challenge that I am facing today. My God is bigger than every creditor who's stolen my money from me. My God is bigger than every person who has cheated me in my business. My God is bigger than every sickness that has plagued my family. My God is bigger. I may not see it, but I'm going to declare it. And what happens when I declare it? The dry bones will come alive. When I declare that my God is so powerful, my God acts for me. Amen. Verse 3. oh, magnify the Lord's greatness, or proclaim with me the Lord's greatness. Let us exalt his name together. I like magnify because, you know, it reminds me of a magnifier. Have you ever seen anything through a magnifier? Amen. Can you imagine a large God being made larger? Amen. I mean, how big is God? And then you're putting a magnifier on that and saying, my God is bigger than what I can even imagine. Magnify God in every situation. The Amalekites are strong, but my God is bigger. Demonetization is a problem, but my God is bigger. Amen. There is persecution happening in the east, west, north, south. My God is bigger. The sickness is causing a lot of problems in our family, but my God is bigger. That cancer has eaten into our finances. No problem. My God is bigger. My God can solve all my problems. When we come to this place where we become the priest in our situations, church, where we say, I don't need, not that you don't need it, I don't want to go to the pastor, I'm going to pray this prayer for myself. When the worship leader stops worshiping, I will continue to worship. When the pastor stops praying, I will continue to pray. When there is no one to lift up their hands and clap and sing unto the Lord, I will do it. When that becomes your lifestyle, can I tell you, you will go beyond the veil with the Lord. Beyond those curtains that stop you from the Lord, you will go in. And you will have an intimate encounter with the Lord, where the Lord will give you directions and he will give you strategies. God, should I fight that Amalekite spirit? Yes. I will be with you. I will stand with you. I will fight for you.